Hey crew, I've got the key to that 22 Rolls-Royce Ghost Black Badge. We are going to take it for a drive, but first, let's check out how it looks on the inside and outside. The Black Badge model adds a dark chrome treatment to things like the Spirit of Ecstasy hood ornament and the Pantheon grille. There are LED projector headlights with LED DRLs. Black gloss treatment for the lower fascia. This one is painted in burnout gray. It's a milky gray color. From the side, we see a set of 21-inch carbon fiber and aluminum wheels. When did you ever think you'd say that about a Rolls-Royce? They're also wrapped in Pirelli P0, real summer performance tires, 255 section front and 285 in the rear. See those red painted calipers on the Black Badge model? You get this purple pinstripe as an option, black window trim. Stepping back to look at the profile, this long, stately sedan. Don't know if the wheel design really does it for me. I'm feeling under the weather, by the way, guys, so that's why my voice is awfully low and I'm doing a lot of mouth breathing. At the back, more dark chrome for the darkened taillight housings. And for the trunk adornment, and for the dual exhaust finishers with quad pipes within. This gray color and the dark chrome treatment do sell the stealthier, speedier side of the Ghost. Just don't think I would have the purple pinstripe or the wheel designs on mine. Let's check out the interior. Opening the coach doors from the center, and looking inside at this black leather interior with perforated seat inserts, these rear seats are heated and ventilated. The leather feels incredibly supple. Purple contrast stitching and piping and Rolls-Royce monograms on the fluffy leather pillows. The doors are covered in leather. You get this technical carbon fiber trim. It's like carbon fiber with a little extra. Rolls-Royce bespoke audio system has these aluminum grates. The door pulls feel so solid. One touch up down windows, memory and two position rear seats, purple leather in here, USB-C ports, and you can't miss the Rolls-Royce umbrellas, which deploy. Before we get inside, just take note of the lamb's wool carpet. So very thick, and because of that, I'm gonna give it a little Gone with the Wind double click of my heels so I don't bring anything in with me. To close up the rear doors, press and hold this button. That's nice. Look at my knee room. I've got a good amount of it, and then the foot pockets are big to slide my feet under. Thigh support is excellent. If I want to adjust this rear seat, I pull down this armrest. You get two cup holders in here that deploy. Your rear seat back and bottom adjustments are there. Little storage cubby in here under the padded armrest. Pop this up for your Spirit of Ecstasy controller for your infotainment system. You got one on each side. Picnic table comes down with the technical carbon trim. You can touch the screen to adjust it. Send the screen and trays away by hitting the button on the side. Your air vents, both here and here, are made of metal, which is so satisfying, as is operating these plungers to open and close the air passageways. There's a four-zone climate control system. I mentioned the rear heated and ventilated seats. If you want to use the middle seat, which does have a seat belt, you just got to get over that drive shaft hump. And then here in the middle, my head doesn't clear the roof, whereas on the sides, it most certainly does. I'm so comfortable. And I've got a Starlight headliner with these little bitty LEDs that makes for such a cool effect at night. There's a leather-wrapped grab handle. I mean, basically, the rear cabin of the Ghost Black Badge has every traditional luxury amenity you can imagine, plus just a few little tech and special features baked in. Also, if you want to get out, you're going to press and push, then you're just going to hold. Minimal effort. Let's check out the front. To close up the rear doors, you need not push. You only have to press lightly on this portion of the handle, and it takes care of the rest. Up front are heated, ventilated, and massaging seats with power adjustments. There are aluminum Rolls-Royce Ghost Black Badge tread plates, more lamb's wool carpets, and even leather padded pillows for your heels to rest on while pressing on the pedals. Like the back doors, the doors up front are covered in leather with tactical carbon fiber. You get 4 one-touch windows, power adjusting and power folding door mirrors with this itty bitty joystick to operate it. Press down on this trigger to open the power operated trunk. Inside we find 18 cubic feet of space. It's a very large trunk, but you can't expand it by folding down the rear seats. You do get a power close and lock feature on the trunk. And if you want to adjust the position of the front right seat, you just hit this button before then using your seat controls. Again, we'll do the Gone with the Wind double click, so don't bring in any dirt or grime. Then I hold this trigger to close up the driver door. There's a heated leather wrapped steering wheel with a very thin rim to it, adjustments on the wheel for your adaptive cruise control system. The gauges have chrome rings and analog borders, but digital inserts. There's a head-up display, leather all over the dashboard, analog clock on the passenger side, touchscreen infotainment system that is quick to respond and has wireless Apple CarPlay. Further down are more metal air vents, a physical volume knob with a leather border, media settings, seat settings, dual zone auto climate with a soft airspeed instead of low. All these dials for the climate settings feel so good. Under the tactical carbon here, we find 2 cup holders. You get a Spirit of Ecstasy controller if you don't want to touch the screen. Under the leather padded armrest is just a little bit of storage. You get a wireless smartphone charging pad, USB-C port, and a DC outlet. Visibility is hindered a little bit by that thicker C-pillar and these ultra-thick headrests. Thankfully, there's standard blind spot monitoring with rear cross traffic. The cabin of the Ghost Black Badge. Material quality and fit and finish is just incredible, as is the actions on all the dials and settings. The only things I'll say, I wouldn't choose purple or this tactical carbon insert, but you can spec it differently. Let's take the Ghost Black Badge for a drive. All right, let's fire it up with the start stop on the left. Now, rumor has it that 12 cylinders just fired on, but I'm struggling to believe it because you'd think there'd be more commotion. I felt like a ripple, like a faint ripple through the body. I heard next to nothing from the exhaust system. I heard those chimes more than anything else. Yet here we are. Now, the Ghost Black Badge only has one drive mode. It's low, so we're not going to use that to start. We are going to go into reverse by pulling left and up on the stock, or rather in and up on the stock. That brings up a high-resolution backup camera with trajectory lines. You can even go in and look at your Ghost Black Badge in 3D if you're feeling vain, or if you're worried about scraping a wheel. There's also a car wash view. So if you plan on taking this $15,000 paint job through an automatic car wash, wouldn't recommend it. You've got this view to kind of line up those front tires with the rails. We're not going to do that today. So let's back on out. In and down for drive. Now, I realize some of you watching already don't think any part of what I do is considered work. I would normally disagree with you, but today you might have a point, because this is going to be effectively 20 minutes of massage therapy. And to that point, let's turn on the massage. Let's see, whole body. Still back massage. Let's keep it simple today. Turn signal sound. Exquisite. Now it almost sounds loud because you don't hear anything else. Powertrain. Oh, you know what? Before that,
world famous horn test. What am I doing? Here we go. So proper. Excuse me. I already have a hood ornament. I don't want you to be my hood ornament from hitting you. Powertrain. 6 3/4 liter twin turbocharged V12. It makes 592 horsepower and 664 pound-feet of torque. Those are increases of 29 horsepower and 37 pound-feet over the standard, just the regular Ghost. That power is routed through an 8-speed automatic gearbox to all four tires. I apologize in advance. I think this video is mostly going to be audible sighs of relief. Because though this is the Black Badge Ghost, this is the sportier Ghost, it is still every bit the floating luxury machine that the standard Ghost is. You still have that four-corner air suspension. You still have the springs on top of the springs, the helper springs, to dampen for the other springs. You still have the Rolls-Royce flag bearer system, the camera system that scans the road surface ahead and looks for any daring, dastardly bumps and primes the suspension to absorb them. And it is still phenomenally quiet. It's a bit like you're driving around with ultra-thick earmuffs on everywhere you go. Because even with earmuffs on, you hear things, right? You're like, oh, okay, that's a little bit of wind noise. Or those... Yep, those are the tires. I think they're making a noise. That was a car that just passed. But you're straining to hear it. And why would you ever strain in a Ghost? So you just let it go. You just relax. The brake pedal is easy to modulate, even though in this Black Badge model, they shorten the pedal travel to give you more of that initial bite. Let's get after that turning radius test. Cranked. Just amazing for a sedan of this size to turn like that. Credit goes to the rear wheel steering system that will pivot those rear wheels in the opposite direction of the fronts. Nice H1 over there. At low speeds, so you're not struggling to maneuver your big luxury barge in tight spaces. Loudest noise I've heard today. It's a huge cement mixer. They did increase the heft of the steering on this Black Badge model, but it's still so delicate. Do you want to see how quick the Ghost Black Badge will get to 60? I do. In preparation for that, I've got my race box set up here, and then we're going to enter the low drive motor, or Sport. It's the Rolls-Royce version of Sport. I'm then going to give it a little bit of a brake boost to get us off the line, and there is a slight uphill, so that's not going to be helping things. We'll see how we do, though. Here goes the neighborhood. There it is in 4.58, call it 4.6 seconds. That is precisely what Rolls-Royce quotes for the Black Badge Ghost 0 to 60. that's impressive considering the uphill there. That means he could probably see quicker. And what was more impressive to me is that I saw the numbers. I knew we were accelerating rather quickly for something that weighs this much. But the only thing I felt was more comfortable because I was being pressed into these sublimely plush leather chairs. Take it out of low right now because it's going to hold onto a gear for us. And I can't see it because there's no tachometer, which is just a weird thing. Yeah, so I just got more comfortable. Even under the hardest acceleration in the Ghost Black Badge. I did hear something, and that was not an unpleasant noise. It was that twin turbo V12 singing for me, a sweet melody. It's the only time you'll hear that engine too. It's just, it, like the transmission, fades completely into the background unless you're pinning it. And then it sounds very good. It does. And it sounds even better on the Black Badge model because they retuned the exhaust system back into low drive mode. Immediately increases that throttle responsiveness. And we're going to try mid-range power once again on an uphill. You can't quite forget. You can't quite forget the twin turbo V12. Oh, goodness. It's a lot of power. It's a lot of motor. And it's a good, good noise. Oh, my goodness. This thing packs a punch. Don't count it out. Do not count out a Black Badge Ghost. If you find yourself between a set of lights, prepare, because unless you're driving a very potent car, or perhaps a Taycan, you might be in trouble. Now, can the Black Badge Ghost excite in more ways than just a straight line? We're gonna find out. Going back into low drive mode, and then turning traction control off. You can do that in a Ghost. You have to hunt around the menus for it, but you can in fact do it. Now I'm gonna carry some speed into this curve. Press hard on those brakes. Not terrible. Turn in. Complaints from the P0s. And then some plow from the nose at the very end. Otherwise, that wasn't terrible. And I half expected it to be. Here's the things that went well. The brakes, 5,700 pounds that they have to reel back in. And yet they did that. There was a little bit of wiggle and there was some nosedive, but they brought us to a stop. The pedal also didn't completely mush on me. That was great. The turn in was slow, but then the stability, the increased stability that they tweak this for the Black Badge model, and then the rear wheel steering system with those rear wheels turning in the same direction as the front, now at higher speeds, gave us less lean than I anticipated. All that to say, you're not gonna be hunting for racetracks in your Rolls-Royce Ghost Black Badge. What you may, however, do is find yourself looking at a curvy road and not want to completely back off it. This car stays poised as the speeds do build. And speaking of speed, speaking of the highway patrol officer right over there, you do need to be paying attention to your speedometer or your head-up display because all of the senses that typically accompany speed in a car are just muted so much here in this Ghost Black Badge. The wind, the tire, the road noise, the engine noise, it all are just held under wraps So unless you're looking, you're just flying down the road and have no idea. Flying down comfortably, I should say. I want a road trip in this thing. You do have adaptive cruise control and a lane keep assist system. I show them in my PUV night drive, along with giving a demonstration of the Rolls-Royce bespoke audio system. So if you want to hear and see those features, watch that PUV night drive. Let's now get into some pricing and competition for this Black Badge Ghost. The starting figure for the standard Ghost is $332,500. If you want the Black Badge, it's $44,000 more than that. This one is tested is $393,500. That is far and away the most expensive of the vehicles I'm about to mention, which include the Bentley Flying Spur W12. That one starts at $219,400. It does make 626 horsepower. It gets to 60 in a scant 3.8 seconds. Its top speed is 207 miles per hour. I did not share the top speed or fuel economy for the Black Badge Ghost. The fuel economy is 12 mpg city, 18 highway, and 14 combined. The top speed is limited to 155 miles per hour. Another ultra long luxurious sedan and powerful one that you can consider is the Mercedes-Maybach S650. That vehicle costs $202,000 to start. It makes 621 horsepower. It gets to 60 in a tie, 4.6 seconds. Ties with this, I should say. And the top speed is also tied at 155 miles per hour. Among those vehicles, here's how the Black Badge measures out. Like the standard Ghost, it is far and away the quietest and the softest, most magical riding experience. I would argue the seats are the most comfortable, and it just gives you this feeling of authority that I feel like those other two cars definitely have, but perhaps not to the same degree. The Mercedes-Maybach has just the most cutting-edge technology and the most rear legroom that make for perhaps the best chauffeured vehicle. The ride quality is still excellent in that vehicle, though not quite as soft as this one. And then the Flying Spur. That one, that's the driver's choice. It actually properly rips. I mean, it would put a very high-end sports car on its heels. It's that good, both in a corner and in a straight line, while still being comfortable, still being exquisitely luxurious, having incredible interior materials. That's a really good option. I would very much consider the Flying Spur if I'm going to be primarily driving it. But here's where I say the Ghost might have the edge. If you get all of your sillies out in a sports car on the weekends and you just want your weekly commute to be the most comfortable, the most at ease, this vehicle just rises above the rest. And the reason I might go Black Badge is not for the wheels and it's not for this interior carbon fiber trim because I don't love those things. It's for the fact that you are now getting the highest end Ghost with that bit of extra power and those blacked out details that I would then spec with different wheels and different interior trim to make just the most boss, and I've used that word before, but truly, truly boss daily driver. I hope you guys have enjoyed this PUV drive review. If you did, please like, comment, and share the video. Subscribe to the channel, hit that bell to get notified, and I'll see you next time.